Yo, it's your man Dijon McCain, and you're now listening to the Juice Podcast. I got a crazy episode for y'all today, man. It's something that everybody's talking about one way or another. Niggas ain't shit. Yeah, I said it, man. I hope y'all enjoy this episode and stay tuned for more.
So, with that being said, man, it's kind of like we getting down to the like. We getting to the nitty gritty. Wait, you know what he say about white girls?
White girls with it.
He didn't mean that view.
Let him say what he said. Whoa, shit. K-Dye, what the fuck? What are we talking about? I thought we had we was on the same level now. Oh, snap.
What are you talking about?
How you gonna say all that shit and then
so
say what?
So, how are they winning?
When I mean white girls, I don't just mean Caucasian women. I mean, like, it's a difference from when you dating a black girl and a girl of no black culture. It's a whole difference. Like, my experience with black girls is, it ain't been a good one. I can speak good on it, like, you know, good things, but I prefer white girls over black girls.
Wait, hold on, motherfucker. Hold on, motherfucker. K-Dot, what the hell? Now, hold on. Pop. So, you started the conversation off saying you wasn't shit.
He proved it.
Then you... Wait. I just want to make sure I ain't tripping. He started the conversation off saying he ain't shit. Now, he got halfway through it. Said some good shit like, yo, you know what I'm saying? I'm just trying to say why I ain't shit, but I really want to find love. That's kind of what you said. And now you saying white girls ain't winning. What the fuck is going on? White girls is winning. White girls winning. I'm tired, y'all. Black girls ain't winning. He said white girls is winning.
Winning, boy. They don't. I done been with white girls. I done been with black girls. And from my experience, the white girls got the upper hand. They don't trip more. You know what I mean? They trip less. You know, black girls be tripping. White girls don't go through your
black
phone.
Black girls be tripping.
White girls don't go through your phone. They'll go through your phone. They'll go through your phone out of curiosity, but it'll take a minute. A black girl. Oh, wait.
Wait, let K-Dot finish.
2 weeks, right? You dating a black girl 2 weeks. She gonna ask you.
Wait, hold on. Don't take the shoe off. She got the shoe off.
Or tell you, you better not be fucking with no other girls. You better not be wasting my. They'll tell you shit like that. Our girl not gonna tell you shit like that. They gonna go with the flow until you give them a reason to go against the flow. Black girls.
So basically, what you said?
So what you basically saying is,
with a white girl, you don't get the drama that you would get with a black girl.
You don't get the drama at all.
You won't.
Until you.
That's what you're saying.
Drama, you don't get the drama. Black girls, you head first in the drama. All
right, my women, go ahead.
First of all, I just want to say this. The anti-blackness within the black community is way too high. And for you to say that you don't date black women because they're this, that, or the third, you're basically telling white women that they're easy for you. So that's basically degrading them in the same sense that you're degrading black women, right? Because you're basically saying you'd rather go for an easier woman than a woman that would challenge you in any way. And I don't agree with that statement that like anybody is winning. It depends. That's what I'm saying. You go for the people who you are. You attract who you are. So you probably that way. You probably one of the niggas that be checking bitches' phones. So you attract girls that gon' check your phone. But if you really looking for an educated woman and you looking for all these different things and y'all like Alexis said, if y'all can build that trust, build that communication. Because I, as a black woman, don't feel the need to check my man's phone. I don't feel the need to do any of that. Because if I trust you and we build that communication, we build that relationship, that's a difference. Like, I don't think it should be like something where you be like, oh, I only date white girls because they don't check my phone. They don't argue with me. They don't do this. They don't do that. First of all, you're perpetuating all these different stereotypes onto black women. And as a black man, you should be ashamed of that in a way. Because I'm pretty sure as a black man, you have a black daughter. And I'm pretty sure you will not feel no comfortable type of way if some man was speaking down on your child. So I think like as black men, y'all need to be conscious of the type of stuff y'all say towards black women. Because at the end of the day, y'all gonna have black daughters who I'm pretty sure y'all will knock a man out in a quick second if he says something silly to your girl. I'm just saying.
Ooh!
He needs some milk! Oh my god!
Wait a minute! K-Dot, hold on!
We on it!
Let's but go it. Ahead, Bonnie. Go ahead.
All right. One problem black women have in today, you see how she said are not liking our races at an all-time high in today's society? Black women frown upon us because we don't like them. It ain't that we don't like them. It's just that we don't prefer them. And they really get mad when you speak out on, oh, I'd rather prefer this and I'm this. They get mad at that because they feel like dating outside. I'm not saying they're against dating outside your race. Low-key, they have some envy against it because you're not praising the black women how you praise them white women, light-skinned women, foreign women.
But wait.
They'll never say it. They'll never say it, but you can clearly see the sneak dissing in. Oh, y'all should feel ashamed. No, we shouldn't.
When I said
I prefer white women over black women, I wasn't preferring white easy women. No one likes the easy women. Everybody knows easy women is hoes. If you're really looking for a woman, you're not really looking for no hoe. And anything easy gonna be a hoe. Black or white. It don't matter. You blue, purple, it doesn't matter. Easy is easy. I'm saying being relationships go through some shit, but you shouldn't have to argue 24/7 every day for a fucking year or a year or so right until you feel like nigga done got it across his head. No.
Wait, hold on.
You shouldn't have to go through that stress.
So what you're saying is, hold on. Hold on. So what you saying?
Black women.
You can have your preference, but your preference should not be downgrading no one else.
I'm not downgrading it. I'm just, I prefer. I said I prefer.
Black women argue with you and they do this and
they do too much to be with them.
Exactly.
From my experience, I'm speaking, that's speaking from my previous experiences through life.
But that's downgrading.
It's downgrading to you because I'm not praising
the population of black women. Say, if you say the black women I've dated have been of this type
of way. I said that from the beginning.
No, you said all black women.
From my dating experiences, I prefer dating white women over black women because black women come with drama regardless.
But you said all black women.
All women come with drama, but it comes less from a white girl. I swear, I promise you, it comes less from a white girl.
Girls like her for her intellect, like her for other reasons. Don't say you like her because she don't bring you drama. Yes, that's messed up. If you don't like somebody, if you don't have a preference, have a preference for something else.
I preference white women and light skinned women because they don't come with too much.
Okay.
Wait, hold on.
But when you say black women, what are you talking about? Are you talking about dark skinned women?
No.
Are you talking about dark skinned? You said light skinned.
When I say black women, I mean black women that act like. You know what I'm talking about. You know that rap?
No, you gotta explain what you're talking about.
You got black women. Hold on, you got black women. You got black women that you'll say some shit to, and they'll just. They ain't gonna be rude about it. They gonna tell
wait.
What
shit? What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
You feel me? You got
give
you
us
got,
some context.
You got women that are like calm manner about certain shit. Then you got women that are loud and do shit to just fuck with the situation more than it had to be. You feel me? All right, bet. Let's put it like this: dating a white girl. Girl text my phone, saying nothing. You feel me? I ain't gonna say what I was doing, but it's the reason why people hit my phone. You feel me? It ain't that, but
hold on. I think we can get to it.
Look, same situation. I'm with a black girl, right? Who is that blowing up your phone? I tell them the situation. Why they hitting up my phone?
Hold on, let me ask you something.
Don't believe that though.
Is the problem with the black women, or is it with the fact that is the problem with the black women, or is it the fact that you trying to get with women who supposedly supposed to think that everything you do is acceptable because you ain't shit?
No,
that the problem?
No,
because it sounds like you want validation.
I ain't shit because I'm single. You feel me?
No, we're not talking about why you ain't shit. What I'm saying is you basically mad at that the black women who don't give you validation for being an ain't shit nigga. Basically, if they don't accept your ain't shit ass, then
it's just when basically go back to what she was saying about trust. If you don't trust somebody, you gonna find shit to argue about. True enough, you're going to find some shit to argue about. If you don't trust that person, you believe speculation.
That's true.
If I'm with a person, I don't know how everybody else trust work. My trust work, I'm going to believe you until you give me reasons to doubt you. You feel me? Everybody not like that, though. Some people, you got to show them, all right, this nigga ain't out here fucking around, so I can really open up, vibe with this nigga. But some people ain't like it. They, one thing they see, and they're going off previous experience of niggas ain't being shit. The one time they see one thing, and send every nigga back down the loop, is, nah, new nigga time. Nope. Because okay. He ain't acting right.
Now, let them talk real quick.
But I'm saying, you just proved the point, though, right? Because he's saying, oh, one experience a girl has with a man, she'd be like, niggas ain't shit. You just said you had experience with black women, and then you automatically don't, black women full of drama. So you're doing the same thing you're telling us not to do. And my thing is, I don't mind nobody having a preference. If you have a preference, that's great. But your preference should never be to downgrade any other woman. Like, if you can clearly say, oh, I don't like women that are full of drama. Because you can find a woman that was in any race, any place, that will search your phone, that will blow your life up. You can say that. Like, I don't like women like that. But to say, oh, black women are some type of way, that's what I have a problem with. You know what I mean? In your experience, like I said, in your experience, maybe it's the people that you attract. Maybe it's the way that you act. Like you said, you an ink shit nigga. So maybe you attract an ink shit women. You know what I mean? So if you change your surroundings or change some type of way, you will find women who are willing to be like, yo, we gonna work together, we gonna build together, we gonna work on that. But I just don't think, like, I think everybody got a preference for people they gonna be with. But your preference... But your preference should never be.
You're saying niggas ain't shit for a while, and
no, but I'm saying
the type of niggas you was into, niggas would be shit. Niggas would be shit, but you haven't. So that's why your perspective is niggas ain't shit.
Hold on, I think you gotta say
that's
it.
All I'm saying.
Wait, you gotta say it one more time, but slow. I don't know what you're talking.
I
about.
I don't know what you said either.
And I want to make sure they know.
She just said basically, I should change the type of females I'm into. Basically, if I don't want to keep getting the same results, I gotta change the type of females I'm into. The females I go after. I'm speaking on experience, so I'm just telling you my experience is this percentage of the females, this particular percentage and race has been black women. It's okay. It's okay, though. It's okay. Because not all black women I've met have all like it. Just majority. It's just, in my head, a majority rules society. But at the same time, they gave you every expression of how niggas ain't shit to them. And basically... That's how y'all think. So if y'all stop going after them type of niggas, we wouldn't be having this niggas ain't shit.
But hold on, let me ask you something.
You would know what you was looking for.
Let me ask you
something. Y'all know what y'all looking for, but are you going after that?
Let me ask you. K-Dot. Hold on. Let me ask you something. Everybody got their word. Let me ask you something. So is your problem that women think you ain't shit or you really ain't shit? Is you basically just told her that, look, accept me because I ain't shit.
I really ain't shit, but I don't try to be. I don't try to pretend like I am shit. You feel me? I'm a straightforward guy. If I want
to
be with you.
So if you ain't shit, how can you expect her to accept you the way you is?
I expect her to accept me as an ain't shit nigga.
But like that's still acceptance, though.
Yeah, you're right. I don't want her to accept me as a nigga as being, he came off kind of charming. And smooth, because you know, most females tell me I'm pretty smooth when I come off. I had females tell me, no, they're not gonna talk to me because I said all the right things when I came and talked to them. That's just okay though, you feel me? But that was how they took it. She might take it, I'm not shit. I'm gonna tell her, I ain't shit. It's all about if you choose to rock with this, ain't shit, or I'm clearly not what you're looking for.
Okay, go ahead, TT. What y'all gotta say? Go ahead. Like, she got some shit to say. She put the laptop up. Y'all can't see it, but she's got the laptop out.
Okay.
Glasses on. Go ahead.
I just want to say, coming from a non-black perspective, right, I think that I'm going to be very conscious of the space that I'm holding because this is a conversation that I cannot personally relate to, right? And I can't because of the environment that I was raised in and who and how I identify. But the one thing that I do want to say is that you sound incredibly uneducated right now. In the sense that you are speaking
right. I got an ass. Hey,
We all speak from experience, and those are valid. And I'm not going to deny you of your experiences because your lived experiences make you who you are today. And I respect those.
Amen.
And I accept
those. Preach.
Right? And so the issue that I'm having is that, and this goes back to what I said earlier of how we all categorize. So do I agree with the statement of saying that y'all are not No, absolutely not. I don't agree with it. And I hate when people say it. I also don't agree with how you're saying that white women don't give you this problem, these problems that black women do. And going back to what Titi said, I agree with her 110% in saying that you're going to find a woman of every single background to give you shit. And I think that you are just the type of women that you are attracting are women that reflect upon who you are as a person. And if you've said yourself that you're not shit, then you're attracting people who may not have grown up in this area, or not this area, of this environment of self-love, of confidence, of accepting who they are. And that goes from every single background. There are Latino women who do not love themselves. There are black women that do not love themselves. There are white women that do not love themselves, et cetera. I could go down the line, right? And then that's going to stem back to home life. That's going to stem back to if their father was present. There are so many different things in psychology that can also prove that. The issue that we have in society is that we constantly categorize people as a whole and we don't sit down and individualize who they are as a person. And so I don't agree with you saying that these black women, quote unquote, are giving you, it's the majority that are giving you problems. Because I know some of my family who's Latinas, crazy as hell, and will give you the same exact problems that you say these black women are giving you. I know white people, right? Being white and Mexican, I know white people that will also give you these problems as well. And so I think you're just going after people who are reflecting who you are and are not going to be toxic to your masculinity because your masculinity feels incredibly threatened. I feel like when you have a strong woman in your presence, and then you have to act like, yo, I'm smooth, I got this, I'm gonna hype myself up. And then you're gonna continue to tell yourself that you're not shit just so you feel better about yourself, reminding yourself that you're gonna make these constant mistakes, but it's okay because you're not shit. Ooh. If that's the life that you wanna live, then continue, but don't bash women from a culture just because those are the experiences that you've had.
I did say I was speaking from experience before I even started.
I understand that, but so you're also, your experience.
No, because you kinda, it's not, you're kinda knocking the experience part. You speaking as a whole, as in we categorize it, but I'm speaking from experience. You're speaking from a whole as we shouldn't do that, because you're right, people of different races will give you different shits. I'm just telling you from my experience. It's like he could experience with Latino women and Japanese women. He could prefer, I ain't going after that, you feel me? I'm gonna stick mm-hmm. to this. I'm gonna stick with what I know that didn't give me shit. I'm speaking on two different types, you feel me? I've experienced the bad, and I've experienced what I think is good, what I thought was bad, and that's just what I get, my interpretation. I know the women I go after, it's either black women, white women. Mm-hmm. Ain't no in between, ain't no getting out, just what I prefer, I know what I prefer, and I'm going after this, and I just split it between what I've been through. Mm-hmm. So I'm categorizing my situation, my experiences. Okay. I'm not categorizing what everybody should think. I know I ain't shit, you feel me? I'm not saying that just because I'm just being honest. I can't lie to you. I could be sitting here lying to you and be like, oh no, I'm perfect. You know, I ain't never did that. I'm not sitting here lying to you. I'm telling you.
Would you rather have him lie?
Would you rather have me sit here lying?
No, I'm saying, I know that.
I feel that. I'm just saying, I'm not lying. I'm just being straight up. I'm a not shit nigga. You gonna go through some shit fucking with me. If you really want to. If I'm fucking with you, I'm gonna fuck with you. I cut everybody off for you. But that ain't with the stage.
Like, your MCM ain't shit. And he just told you he ain't shit, but you still
want. I don't think it's gonna get better just for the.
I said, you want the women who massage your masculinity.
I definitely do, because people pick their poison and choose what they want to do.
So that's what we get into. That's the bottom line.
And choose who they want to be with. But at the end of the day, I don't know. It's all about a pick your poison. You be with who you want to be with. You going to put up with what you want to put up with. It's either bullshit or a motherfucker that's going to act right. Or a motherfucker that's going to give you a little bit of both.
So you just got to go through it. Real quick. I'm going to let you talk. But in conclusion, I'm going to say this shit one more time. In conclusion, we wrapping up, y'all. It's 12:19 a.m. We've been killing this shit. I love them for helping me with this first podcast, man. It's been a lot. In conclusion, what can men and women both do to, like, solve this whole back and forth niggas ain't shit talk, women ain't shit talk? What can we do to love each other more, or what's some solutions?
Talk it out. Trust each other.
Hold on, y'all ain't got the damn mic. Hold the shit y'all ass down. Y'all wasn't saying, y'all wasn't saying nothing the whole talk. Now they want to say something. Go ahead.
To answer your question specifically.
Let's just ride out. Let's just ride out.
All right, okay.
Let's ride out.
I think that language is more important. Words are powerful, and we always forget that. Language is how you navigate situations. And so, in reference to how I want to touch back on this conversation, and you saying,
she like, look, nigga, I'm still trying to get your ass right now. I'm still on your ass. We ain't close until I get your ass right now.
Saying that you're speaking from your experiences, don't say white women are winning. Because in general, you can say white women are winning in my life. That's a completely different connotation than just saying white women are living in general. And you're being reckless with the way that you say things, just as a million other people are being reckless with the way that they say things. If you are careful for how you word things, it can make all your intent is not always going to align with your impact. When you said white women
are winning,
your intent is never going to align with your impact.
I don't know, size.
That
I'm
is
just,
why you
know,
need to own your impact like and own the responsibility of the way that made someone feel. Don't
perfect.
Say that's not what I meant, because then you're just being a coward. You can't say but and then exclude just the words that you said before. If I said, yeah, you're great, but then you're not going to worry about what I said before that. You're not going to think you're great anymore. That's the language that matters and the context that needs to be provided in those types of conversations.
Perfect. In conclusion.
Yeah,
in conclusion, you look like you got some.
No, I'm just going to say, like, even like the whole conversation about niggas ain't shit and women ain't this, blah, 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 blah. I think we have those conversations like jokingly, but kind of like I said, we should be like conscious of the language. Like, me personally, I don't go after ain't shit men. You know what I mean? Like, personally. So I think like the way we can start like, you know, loving each other better.
Just pissed about like, just pissed like 50 guys off. Like, God damn it, man. Trying to get on with TT, man. She said, nah, girl, you ain't that special.
Like, I think the way we can start like doing those things is having those more healthy conversations and addressing those problems in our society and being honest from the jump. Like, if you're looking for a relationship, say that. If you're not, say that. Everybody just be honest on both sides so that people don't get hurt. Because I know a lot of girls who like probably like listening like, girl, whatever, niggas ain't shit. Because they, you know what I mean? Because dudes need to be more honest the same way females need to be more honest. So if people just are honest about their intentions, like, I respect you admitting that you're an ain't shit nigga. You know what I mean? Like, I respect that. Not a lot of dudes will say that. A lot of dudes will sit here and be like, no, I'm 100% loyal, I'm faithful, you know what I mean? But, you know, I think, like, the more honest we are, the healthier we can all be, and everybody can find what they're looking for. And that's it.
In conclusion.
Right. Yeah. I can't help agree.
Hold on, real quick. The audience, like, where the fuck this nigga come
right,
from?
Like, who is this voice?
Who is this voice?
I ain't said nothing all episode. Nothing.
He been sitting right here clean as hell,
y'all.
This
first episode, I swear, they killed it. I just let them go ahead and do it, because, like, the conversation was great. I mean, I can't help but agree with everybody that was just talking. And I could agree from my man's perspective at how he's fed up with women. That's what they basically want. Someone that's not lying to them. Someone that's going to tell them straight up, this is what I want. This is how I'm going to get it. But.
You said but. See, there's a language but, right there. Invalidating what you just said.
Look, in conclusion.
Women say, niggas ain't shit. There's some good men out there, ladies. Y'all just not looking in the right places.
Thank you. That is true.
And when my man to my left says white women are winning, there's some white girls out there that's winning. But no, hey, look. You got to look. You got to look all over the map. I'm telling you. Women are beautiful no matter what skin color they are, no matter what they bring to the table. You got to find a woman that's for you.
Yo. Yo. Crazy episode, right? I told y'all it was going to be wild. Thank y'all so much for listening to my podcast. This is my very first episode. The podcast is about having authentic conversations, controversial conversations, and vulnerable conversations, you know? And on this episode, I just wanted to challenge different perspectives. So, hope that y'all enjoyed it, and stay tuned for the next episode.